Arizona versus the United States, a showdown in the U.S. Supreme Court next week over SB 1070. The High Court will hear arguments in Governor Jan Brewer's appeal of a ruling that blocked police from enforcing the law's most controversial elements. U.S. District Judge Susan Bolton stopped enforcement of a requirement that police, while enforcing their other laws, question people's immigration status if officers suspect they are in the country illegally. Former Arizona Attorneys General Grant Woods and Terry Goddard, along with 42 other former attorneys general, filed a court brief arguing that SB 1070 weakens public safety and law enforcement. With me now to talk about the detail of the brief is former Attorney General Grant Woods. Grant, welcome back.
We've
had you on the show before. In many respects, this is Grant Woods and Terry Goddard versus Arizona. Your names are on the caption. There are 42 other attorneys general who joined, but your names are there. How did this come to be?
Well, I think my position on SB 1070 has been pretty clear from the beginning, and I've felt it's unconstitutional. It's bad public policy, and I led in discussions with a lot of people who are going to intervene and get involved with this Supreme Court decision by filing their own amicus briefs. I told them I'd be glad to help out however I could. And then some of the groups, the ACLU, thought that was kind of intriguing. We've been on the opposite sides of many issues. I went to the Supreme Court and argued against the ACLU on a case. So the idea that we'd be on the same side, I guess, was intriguing, and it went from there. And ultimately, we ended up having, as you said, 42 attorneys general, including Bruce Babbitt, former Arizona attorney general. So we had three former attorneys general from Arizona, along with all of our colleagues from around the United States.
Now, one of the things that really jumps out at you from the brief, in fact, it's the opening paragraph of the brief, is the Chandler raid, that incident in which you played a very prominent role in terms of dealing with the aftermath of it. That seems to be the thread that ties the various arguments together. Talk about that.
Sure. Well, if people recall, it was toward the end of my term in, I think, 1997, it was much ballyhooed that there was a big enforcement effort taking place in Chandler. It was an effort between the local Chandler police and the Border Patrol, where they were going to round up, their words, illegal aliens. And at the time, it got all positive press, if you look back on it, for those 3 days. But the more I heard from people in Chandler about what really went on, the more concerned I was. So I had questionable jurisdiction, maybe you could say, but it seemed to me if civil rights was going to be a major part of our platform at the Attorney General's office, which it was, then I should get involved. So we did get involved. We looked at it, and what we found was unacceptable, and that is that people were routinely stopped on the streets and pulled over in their cars for one reason and one reason only, and that's because they were brown-skinned. That was it. We listened to the tapes. The tapes were amazing. They would identify the car, say, no probable cause, pull them over. Very rarely do you have police officers actually saying the words no probable cause. So the reason that's important here is because there's a real-life example of what happened when local law enforcement got involved in immigration efforts such as is contemplated in SB 1070. What happens is people end up getting profiled. So you have that, combine it with now flash forward to 2012, and what the Justice Department has found is systematic profiling going on of Latinos by the Sheriff's Department.
Maricopa County
Sheriff's Office. That's it just shows how unacceptable this is. The good news was, at the conclusion of all the hoopla over the results of our study, the Attorney General of the United States, Janet Reno, and Doris Meisner, who was the head of INS, got on a call with me, and they said, "What do you want, kind of, to make this calm down?" And I said, "What I want for this to never happen again in the United States." And the Attorney General told me, "You got it. It won't. It's not going to happen again on our watch." And she was good to her word. It didn't happen again under the Clinton administration, but it's back. And it's back in our state leading the way. Ironic, given the predominance of the Mexican culture in the history of the state of Arizona, in the present of our state, and in the future of our state, in the number of Latinos who live here. Our state should be leading the effort in other directions, not in this direction. So I thought it was incumbent on for people like myself to stand up and say, you know what, this is wrong, and to let the justices know that we have a real-life example here going on in Arizona. We had it in the 90s. We have it today of what will happen under 1070.
Well, and that's another interesting aspect of the brief. You don't pull any punches. It doesn't say there's a possibility of racial profiling. This may give rise to unfortunate circumstances. You just say it will occur. If this law goes into effect, that racial profiling will occur.
Yeah, that's our view, and that's my view. That's the view of former Attorney General Goddard, former Attorney General Babbitt, and the other 42 attorneys, former attorneys general. Why? Because we have experience in law enforcement, and we understand that even with best intentions, these things happen. You have in SB 1070 a really disturbing private right to sue police officers and police departments if they're not enforcing immigration laws appropriately, supposedly, which again will shift the priorities so that people who don't want to get sued, so that they really go the other way here.
And that's one of the points that you make. You make three points as to what's wrong with SB 1070 from law enforcement perspective, that one being effectively the intimidation of law enforcement.
Right.
If they don't enforce it, they'll be sued.
Right.
The other is the impact on the relationship between law enforcement and the community.
Right. And I view that as extremely serious here. I think we understand, most people believe in this country, that community policing works. And that is, the police officers are not seen as Javert from Les Mis. You know, they're seen as part of the fabric of the community. People in the community view them as an ally, as an asset, so that people feel free to go to police officers.
And that relationship will be negatively impacted.
It's going to be negatively impacted in a big way because the immigrant.
On that note, I'm sorry, we're out of time. We'll have to end it there.
And hopefully, we can get around that with this. If the court will rule the way the lower courts and Judge Bolton has ruled, then we can get back to some more sanity here in community policing. Let the police officers do their real jobs.
Karen Woods, thanks for joining us on Horizonte.